Hua?
Yes, hi. We
Okay.
are live. Hi, Evan, how are you?
So I'm good. I'm just gonna be sharing this live with all my fans. I think the camera is a little tilted. If you can just check that. It's coming like this.
Okay, we'll just change the frame.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just posting this on my page. So are we straight now
Yeah.
in that? Okay. Hi everyone, what's up? And we're live with Delhi Times and let's go.
Okay, how's it going?
It's going good. Yesterday was a very fun day. I was here for an event and Sonu ji also was there and we sang together Kabhi Alvida Na Kehna and Abhi Mujh Mein Kahin. So that was a very memorable moment for me. He's been a huge inspiration for me. So for that to happen, it was a dream come true.
Would you like to sing a few lines here again? I'm sure we
Sure.
missed you there.
कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना।
Thank you, Ma. So, when we begin to talk about your work, I would like to know about one song that you're really proud of.
ओके One song that I'm really, really proud of is Tere Mere from the movie Chef. I think I personally gave it my all. That was one of the only songs probably where I feel that every lyric, every word of the song has been felt by me. And it was the most genuine, most honest song from my end. And even vocally, I feel ki it shows a lot of my range as a singer. So Tere Mere is definitely something I'm really proud of.
Would you mind singing a line or two?
तेरे मेरे दरमिया है बातें अनकही, तू वहां है मैं यहाँ क्यों साथ हम नहीं, फैसले जो किए फासले ही मिले, राहें जुदा क्यों हो गए, ना तू गलत ना मैं सही, ले जा मुझे साथ तेरे, मुझको ना रहना साथ मेरे, ले जा मुझे, ले जा मुझे।
Thank you. Okay, Aman, so what surprise do you have in store for your fans? You hinted something on your Twitter.
Yeah, so December is a really special month for all my fans, for all the Armanians. It's been a long time since a film song has come, and this month I released one song already. It's called Jab Se Mera Dil, which is doing really well online. There are two more songs coming from my end. One really big song from the movie Cheat India, which features Imran Hashmi, and this will be my third song with him, so you could say it's a hat trick together. And it's a very special song. I'm going to be saying, revealing much more about it a few days later. Now I have to be tight-lipped, but it's a very special song, and I think we're ending the year on a very good note. It's festive time. Everyone's going to be with their families and friends and people who they love. So it's the perfect time to drop a romantic song. And so it's coming very, very soon. And I keep giving my fans surprises. I don't tell them when it's releasing. Even I don't know when it's releasing. So I'm surprised myself when it comes out. But yeah, it's going to be an amazing last month to 2018. And 2019 overall is going to be a great year. A lot of new stuff coming up. One collaboration with Amal as well, coming up for an Ajay Devgn movie. So looking forward to that as well.
And I've was just reading up, and you recently were talking about remixes on your Twitter posts as well. And I think since you have done, and most of your songs have been in,
yes,
been a hit, you know?
Yes.
So I just want to understand that, where do you stand on this remix debate? When every time we keep on hearing this, that remix.
See, now I don't think it's anymore a debate. It's now become a trend where everyone is doing it,
mm-hmm.
and. Matlab, even if we say yes or no, if you don't like it or like it, we have to go ahead with it because that's the trend. And if you don't flow with the trend, you get left behind. So I mean, in this whole, amidst the whole recreation thing, my only job is to see that the recreation is well done. You know, many a times a recreation is not done in the right manner. And I feel like all the recreations that I have done in the recent past, maybe ghar se nikalte hi tumhe apna banane ka pyar manga hai aise na mujhe tum dekho, I've done quite a few recreations in this span of my career. I feel like they've been very tastefully done. They've been done in a way which doesn't spoil the original song, yet it brings something new to the table. So I feel that's what a recreation should be. It shouldn't just be a complete mashup of the song and just putting new beats and using the same song as is. So we have not done that. Even in Ghar Se Nikalte, we have changed the antras. Parab wahan wo rehti nahi, maine suna wo ja chuki hai. These are lines which are not there in the original. So doing something new yet maintaining that classic feel, I think that's what has been the effort from my end on all my recreated songs. And probably in a few months, recreation should die down. I mean, the trend is really high now. Even Aankh Mare and all these songs have come out. A lot of recreations are coming out. And they're getting popular. So the thing is that the moment they get hugely popular, people think that, oh, recreations are getting more popular, we should do more recreations. So that's how the whole cycle begins again. I mean, if we can't put a hard stop to it, but it'll only fade out because people will start wanting more and more original music. That's it.
Okay, and who have been your musical influences, like, since your childhood?
There have been many.
We have followed through. We all have this childhood hero, and, you know, we dream about, and we end up, you know, okay, one day we would want to become like.
I mean, my dream come true moment was yesterday when I was with Sonu Nigam. So he's been a huge inspiration for me,
mm-hmm.
and I've always looked up to him. And I met him yesterday. I met him a couple of times before as well, but I sang with him yesterday, which was a very big moment for me.
Mm-hmm.
And apart from Sonuji, Kishore Kumar has also been someone who I've really looked up to, Mohammad Rafi Saab. But Sonu Nigam has been my hero. I think he has been one of those guiding forces for me. He's been my my guru who's not been in front of me, who's not been teaching me, but I've learned so much from him by just listening to his songs. You know, so yeah.
How much of an inspiration is your brother to you?
My brother has been actually the most important, has played the most important role in my career. Not because of the songs that were done, but because of the training he has given me, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Because all the songs that I've sung with him, I've had the most toughest recordings with him. It's not been very easy. We fight a lot. And he fights with me to get the best out of me. And I think that's something that, you know, I look up to, because he fights for the best in every voice, be it probably Arijit Singh singing for him or Sonuji singing for him or any other singing for him, any other person singing for him. He wants the best out of them. And that's a quality that I really look up to. It's really inspirational. And I feel like the range of work that he has done in the last 3 years, you know, he's done a slew of hits like Suraj Duba Hai, Main Hoon Hero Tera, So Aasman, Buddhu Saman, Kar Gai Chul, Roke Na Roke Naina, Main Rahun Ye Na Rahun. He's done a lot of variation. There has been out and out party numbers like Suraj Duba and Chul, while on the same hand there's Roke Na Roke Naina and Main Hoon Hero Tera and Main Rahun Ye Na Rahun. So I really love the range that he's put out in the last 2-3 years, and I'm proud of the composer that he is. Yeah.
Industry always.
Yeah.
What is it that you think that makes you two click? What there would be some USP that you think?
Actually, the best part about us is that we're not a duo. You know, it's not that we come as Amal Arman or like a Saleem Suleiman or a Vishal Shekhar. And that's been a conscious effort from our end, not to restrict ourselves as musicians, because when you do that, you start working only together. And that is not something that our dad wanted us to do. My dad wanted me to sing with as many composers as possible, and my brother to work with as many singers as possible. So I think our individual musicality has shown because of not being a duo, but we work so much together, collaborate so much together, and our Jodi has been successful whenever Amal and me come together on a song, when he's composed a song and I've sung it. It's gone on to do amazingly well. So that just shows that, pairings definitely do matter, and teamwork really does matter. There have been these Jodis in the industry since a long time. Like, there's Jatin Lalit with Udit Narayan, and Kumar Shanu with Nadeem Shravan. Kumar Shanu being the singer for almost all their super hits. So I personally feel like it's a Jodi from above. You have nothing to do about it. It just happens. It just clicks. Mm-hmm. And I happen to have the Jodi right in my family, so I think it's the best feeling ever.
Coming to your family, and as you have been talking about the hardships that everyone faces in the beginning of a career,
yeah.
It's often believed that a music team is an easy choice to you. Your uncle being in the music family, your father being in the music family. Was it an easy choice for you?
Not at all, actually. The choice of choosing singing as a career was easy, because I knew that this is all that I have to do. But making my own name and singing songs was a different route I took, because personally, we are not very close to my other family, which is Anu Malik and his family. They were the most successful Maliks than my dad. And we have come up in a very different way. We have seen life in a very different way. We have seen our dad wanting to succeed but not succeed, and always, having failure at every step. And that has taught us and got this passion in me and Amal to, make it big. So honestly, using any of my family name to my advantage never happened for me, because we were Amal and Arman. We never portrayed ourselves as Amal and Arman Malik. It just happened to be that the surname is part of our name. And even when I entered on Saregamapa Little Champs, I strictly went there saying I'm Arman from Mumbai, and this is how I sing, because I want people to judge me on my talent, not because I come from a family. And it so happened that at that show, when I progressed further into the top 10 and I came on the 7th position, I was eliminated on the pretext saying that, I will get work because I am from a family of music. And I don't believe that. I believe that I might get access to the door of opportunity. But when you open the door and when you go inside and there's a mic in front of you and you're asked to sing, and if you can't deliver, I don't think anything can happen. So I believe that talent is the final test of everyone. Yes, I do agree that there are a lot of relationships in the industry that probably my father has kept over these years, because he has worked with Salman Khan and his family extensively. That's how my first big break happened. But if I had not sung songs well, I don't think that would have gone further, which is why I believe that talent is the most important thing. And many people do believe that if you come from a family, example, the whole nepotism thing where actors, belonging from the families. I believe that if in your first film, if you don't act well, I don't think people will watch you from the second film. It's as simple as that. Your talent is very important. Be whoever you are from whichever family. Everyone is ultimately based on their talent. And definitely there is one negative aspect to it as well, where people who are really talented as well don't get the door of opportunity. But I just feel people who are from these families should not be apologetic about being from these families. We are born, it's not that we have chosen ourselves to be in this family. We are from this family, we are happy to be from this family. But there is talent backing us. It's not just because we are from a family, we are getting opportunities and we are doing well in life. I believe that if you put me and other singers together in one room and you tell us all to sing, I know that I'll be able to deliver. I know that I'll be able to sing. So I think talent is the most important quality everyone should have.
Rightly said. I think we'll take a short break from our questions, because there are a lot of requests.
I'm sure there are a lot of requests for songs.
Indrani wants to sing Jab Se Mera Dil.
Okay, that's my latest song which has come out. For Jab Se Mera Dil?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me also go on to that live chat. Is it? One sec, let me just check. What all are they saying? Are they? Oh, yeah.
Your fans want to know where is your watch?
My watch. Oh, they
I'm surprised
notice.
that you're not wearing your watch.
My watch. Actually, it didn't go with this outfit, so I didn't wear it. But otherwise, I'm always wearing my watch.
Nilofar Shaheen has said, can you please sing Hua Hai Aaj Pehli Baar?
Okay, so there are many fans who have requested for Jab Se Mera Dil,
Yeah.
and for some other songs as well. So let's start with Jab Se Mera Dil. So जब से मेरा दिल तेरा हुआ पूछो ना मुझको मुझे क्या हुआ अब तेरी बाहों में जीना मुझे वरना है मर जाना जब से मेरा दिल तेरा हुआ पूछो ना मुझको मुझे क्या हुआ अब तेरी बाहों में जीना मुझे वरना है मर जाना हुआ है आज पहली बार जो ऐसे मुस्कुराया हूँ तुम्हें देखा तो जाना है कि क्यों दुनिया में आया हूँ ये जा ले करके जा मेरी तुम्हें जीने में आया हूँ मैं तुमसे इश्क करने की इजाजत रब से लाया हूँ
Thank you.
सो दैट इज अ मैशअप ऑफ जब से मेरा दिल विथ हुआ है आज पहली बार सॉरी आई एम जस्ट इन द मॉर्निंग मूड एंड माय
Not a
टंग इज
morning
ट्विस्टिंग
person, are you?
आई एम नॉट अ मॉर्निंग पर्सन बिकॉज आई स्लीप सो लेट But actually woke up quite early today, but still, I don't know, I'm still sleepy.
So then your fans have noticed why your eyes look so tired.
Oh, okay. They are
Another
saying.
request is from Samra Hussain. Please sing few lines of Bol Do Na Zara.
Okay.
And kaun
कौन तुझे?
हाँ मैं से गया कौन तुझे
Okay. This is कौन तुझे? So this is for the fans again. तू आती है सीने में जब जब सांसें भरता हूँ तेरे दिल की गलियों से मैं हर रोज गुजरता हूँ हवा के जैसे चलती है तू मैं रेत जैसे उड़ता हूँ कौन तुझे यूं प्यार करेगा जैसे मैं करता हूँ That is gone tujhe. And now my voice is a little tired, so I'm not going to be singing. But we're going to be taking
Yeah, I think you should
questions.
take a few names who have been complaining that you have if you can say yeah you're avoiding and if you can just say their names once.
Oh.
Harshita is one.
Okay, so there is Indrani Mukherjee. There is. Wait, I know a few.
Swarna, cutie.
Bhavya Paruthi, Hetal Patel. Armanian girl, Armanian girl. Okay, I don't know what your name is, but thank you for such a cute name. Nigar Sahiba, Rutri Biswal, Ruby Islam, Dipanita Ghosh, Rajashree Mondal. Lot of fans joining in right now.
Yeah, and they also want you to sing in Tamil.
That's Sukhan Saini.
Buddhika Chamini has said if you can please sing in Tamil.
My voice is a little tired. I will do another live where I'll sing in Tamil, but yeah, as of now I'm gonna be giving my voice a break. But lots of love to all the fans who are logging in. I'm checking out all your comments, and as you can see all the hearts, flying from right to left on my screen as well. Someone must be saying I'm always on my phone. Yes, I'm always on my phone. And people are saying I'm a little tired. I'm always tired 24/7, but that's because I'm working to give songs to only you guys. So you can't complain.
Okay, I think then let's have let's take a few questions.
Okay.
So, ever thought of being a judge on a reality TV show? It has happened or it's about to happen?
As I said, surprises for my fans. Don't want to say anything. A lot of stuff coming up for all my fans, and I want to leave it at that, because a surprise is best when it's not spoiled, you know. So keeping that question for later on, keeping that answer for later on.
Okay. So what kind of music is your stress buster?
My stress buster is actually English music. I listen to a lot of English music.
I would like to hear that from you.
I actually have been writing a lot of English songs
mm-hmm.
of my own.
Lovely.
And probably 2019 would be the year when many of my fans will listen to my English songs as well. It's been a passion of mine since a long time. And I just feel like probably in the coming few years, you'll see a lot of different songs coming from my end.
Would you like to give a teaser?
I can't give a teaser right now because I don't know when that is going to be happening. But yeah, it's coming soon. All my fans know I sing in English.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. That'll come soon.
I can see a lot of love pouring from Delhi, and they are asking that.
Oh, my Delhi Armanians are like crazy. Like it's been unfair for them because I have not done a live concert in Delhi till now, and I don't know why it's not happened. But it's just I believe in in a lot of, you know, timing, luck, and fate, and stuff like that. So I believe it'll happen at the right time. But that right time's not happened. You know, all these years, but hopefully soon it happens for all my Delhi Armanians. I personally feel like a lot of love comes from Delhi. Even on my social media, I've been tracking which cities are the maximum where my followers are, and Delhi always remains at the top and always comes within the top three cities. So lots of love to all my Delhi fans, and don't worry, main aa raha hu show ke saath.
One more thing that you mentioned to us in your previous interview, that
yeah.
If ever, like, you hardly go, you know, away from your diet, but if there has to be a cheat day, it will be in Delhi, something of the sort. So is there any cheat for Delhi, like, if you wanna?
I mean, the thing is, you know, whenever I come to Delhi, it's always been you know, quickly in and quickly out. I do my thing, my work and my show, and just, you know, fly back to Bombay. But even this time, right now, after this interview, I'm going to be immediately taking a flight back home. But I wish that I can stay a little longer. Last time I said I'd like to go to, you know, Chandni Chowk and, you know, all these places and see, you know, all these places and eat food at these places. You know, the street style food. But I think that'll happen on the next trip here, not on this trip. I'm still on my diet. I've been having a few health issues which I've been sorting out. So street food is definitely not an option for me as of now. But yeah, when I'm like back to the pink of health, I'll be going to the streets of Delhi, and I'll take Delhi Times with me. What say? Are you guys ready?
We would love to come.
Yeah, we'll go together. We'll have lunch or dinner or whatever and have a blast in Delhi. What's his name?
Atar
Rahman. Okay, hi Atar Rahman. Lots of love to you. And hi on... okay, he says, I'm also a singer. So, just wishing you luck for all your songs and put out stuff on YouTube. I think that's the best platform.
Kain Upasana Prajapati Singh, I love your all the songs. Your voice takes me somewhere else.
Okay, where does it take you? Say something for Bangladeshi Armanians. Oh yeah, there are loads of Armanians in Bangladesh. And bahut jald ek concert bhi hone wala hai, which I'll be telling you about. So lots of love to all my Bangladeshi Armanians and my Bangla fans as well. Bipasha Sarkar, Hetal Patel, Muskan.
Oh God, okay, there's this...
A name so sweet that it's twice.
There's this message from Raghav Sharma which says, please sing Uchi a building, otherwise this live chat doesn't work.
Oh.
I don't know.
ओके व्हाई डज द लाइव चैट नॉट वर्क इफ आई डोंट सिंग ऊंची बिल्डिंग, मतलब मेरा गाना तो नहीं है एंड आई डोंट वांट टू मिमिक दिस वॉइस इन माय अंकल्स वॉइस, सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू बी सिंगिंग दिस सॉन्ग, सो इफ यू डोंट स्टे इन दिस लाइव बाय.
Okay, mostly Banerjee suggesting try the Lotus Temple, you'll get some peaceful atmosphere.
Oh, what is Lotus Temple?
Lotus Temple is in Delhi. So
oh, okay.
So we're talking about Delhi, so they're suggesting you. And
oh, lovely.
Shreya Sinha is saying come to Delhi and have Delhi's Chole Bhature.
Oh, okay. I actually, I've had Chole Bhature here, but I don't remember which place I'd had it at. But yeah, it's very tasty and full of butter and ghee and everything. So I'll definitely try more of that on my next trip. And I'm a big foodie actually. You can't stop me from eating food. So I think that we have to fix a date with Delhi Times now. Next
yeah,
trip.
Yeah, you're looking forward to it.
That we all go out and just have you all find the right spot for me. So
that
we'll so then we will overeat that day and it'll be a cheat day for all of us.
Talking about your diet, I read somewhere that you know you met Salman and Salman actually gave you a few tips and
yeah.
managed to lose some weight.
Yeah.
That.
Well, as you all know, he's a fitness freak, and when it comes to his regime and his workouts and all, he's very serious when it comes to all of that. And whoever is around him and whoever he's mentoring as well, you know, follow the same thing. And he put me on these workouts, and he told me you have to follow a diet and control what you're eating. And ever since then, I've been on, you know, on these diets on and off. Obviously, I can't just be on a diet. I have to enjoy a little bit as well. So I do have my cheat days in between. But yeah, he's the one who actually put me onto this whole health thing and having my health in the right place. So all thanks to Salman bhai. I guess I have lost the weight that you wanted me to lose.
Action plans? Don't tell me that it's a surprise.
No, it's not. Actually, I don't. The love I have for singing and music is just not the same for acting. There are some people who are really passionate about being in front of the screen. I like being in front of the screen, but only for my songs. Like if you've seen me in Ghar Se Nikalte Hi in the music video, you've seen me in Ajana Ferrari Mein in the music video. So I'm going to be doing more of that. But acting in films, I don't know yet. I'm not sure about that. I feel like I'm still too young and I have a lot to learn when it comes to acting. I've learned for 12 years, 13 years my music. So, that you know, I feel like the same kind of effort needs to go in my acting. But as a thing, if you give me a choice between singing and acting, I'll always choose singing. Acting is something that I'm not that fond of. It's as simple as that.
Okay, as we are about to end, if you can just say hi to Armani and Payal. She has written a couple of times.
Armani and Payal. Okay. Hi, Armani and Payal. Lots of love to you. And I really like how all my fans have Armanian in their usernames and their display names. So, lots of love to you guys. And
Sukhan Saini is also saying, I really want to see you singing for Shah Rukh, sir.
Yes, Sukhan, hopefully that happens soon. It's all on Shah Rukh, sir, because he actually expressed a wish of, you know, he really likes my voice and he, in the future, would love to see a song where he's acting and where I'm singing. So hopefully, fingers crossed, only the fans can make this happen, that it happens soon and probably in one of his next movies, after Zero. So, yeah, hopefully that happens soon. King of Romance and Prince of Romance together.
Great. Do we have more from Insta? Do you want to take some names?
Lots of names. Harshita.
Okay. So some people are on Facebook and some are on Instagram.
Bhavna. Sunaina.
Okay. Hi Sunaina. Hi Bhavna. Hi Harshita.
Fatima.
Fatima
Arman 22.
Fatima Arman 22. Okay. So lots of love to all my Armanians, all my fans out there. Thank you for joining this live session with me and Delhi Times. This has happened twice till now and it's been always a fun session with Delhi Times. And the next time probably, instead of doing a simple session like this, we'll be going out into Delhi and experiencing Delhi firsthand. So stay tuned for that. Lots of love. And lots of love to the Delhi Times team for always making a good session with you guys. And peace out. New songs releasing, ending December on a great note. So stay tuned for all my surprises.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.